Hi everyone, welcome to a brand new episode of McLaren Substitute Teacher, where we give homeschooling a Grand Prix twist. If you ever wondered about the science and technology of Formula One, then this is the place. Today's lesson is brought to you by Stephen, who works with our partners at Dell Technologies. Watch and learn.
Hi, I'm Gemma, and I'm joined by this week's McLaren Substitute Teacher, it's Stephen.
Hi, I'm Stephen from Dell Technologies.
So Stephen, what is on the whiteboard today?
So today is one for the tech heads out there. We're learning all about network performance and the need for speed.
But this is Formula One, surely it's all about the speed?
Not always. It's also about great communication and knowing how to react.
But also doing things very quickly?
Ideally in a couple of milliseconds. And we're going to talk about how we get data from the car to the pit lane and then back to here, the McLaren Technology Center.
Great, well let's head to the classroom then, quickly. Stephen, you work for one of the world's biggest IT companies, and sometimes I even struggle to use a calculator. So how about we start with the basics?
Absolutely. Pretty much all computer technology begins with a network. Really, it's just two electronic devices, such as a laptop, that are linked together. If people are watching this, they're already part of a network, the internet.
Okay, so we've got networks at home, at school, and in the workplace.
Exactly, and many of us have a number of devices all connected online, usually through Wi-Fi. And that could be a mobile phone, a tablet, a personal computer, or a gaming device.
That's assuming that you remember all the passwords to all of these devices.
Well, that definitely helps. The internet is one enormous network connecting millions of devices across the world, allowing us to share resources such as printers, files, videos, music, as well as applications and games. But it's also important for receiving things such as email.
And of course, downloading all the latest news from McLaren.
Of course. The internet does throw up the occasional glitch. Sometimes there can be delays in sending or receiving information, which can be really annoying when you're playing online games.
Oh yes, the dreaded buffering.
And that's the last thing you want during a Grand Prix. Mm-hmm. Speed is of the essence, not just at the track, but in your network. A race team needs information to be sent and received in the fastest possible time. It could make the difference between winning and losing.
I mean, I feel just stressed thinking about it. So what kind of information gets transferred over a race weekend?
A Formula One car is packed with technology to make the car go faster and to stop faster, as well as monitoring its performance.
While the car's actually on the track?
Exactly. The two McLaren cars reach speed of over 200 miles an hour. Each one of the cars have over 300 sensors streaming 100,000 data points per second.
Wow.
That data is sent in real time from the trackside IT rig and relayed back to here, the MTC in the UK. A setup is called Mission Control.
So there are people working here on the car performance over the race weekend?
McLaren has over 30 people back at base monitoring the car, sending information to the trackside and helping decide on the strategy. If the network slows down in sending and receiving information, that can make a really big difference.
So what kind of things might affect the network performance?
It can be a number of things, but today we're going to look specifically at bandwidth and latency.
Okay, bring it on. So, what is the difference between bandwidth and latency?
Bandwidth tends to confuse people. They think it's about speed, how quickly things can be sent from one place to another. But in fact, it's actually about size. Bandwidth measures the capacity, how much data at any one time you can send from one place to the next. So it's measured in bits per second.
Ah, thank you for clearing that up. Some bandwidth fake news.
So while bandwidth is about volume, latency is about time, more specifically about the delay. So how long it takes from data to travel from its source to its destination, and it's measured in milliseconds.
Oh, I don't think my watch measures milliseconds.
A millisecond is 1/1000th of a second. Ooh. Incredibly small. Yeah. You have to remember, in optimal conditions, data can travel at the speed of light, but in many situations, data travels much, much slower.
So milliseconds slower?
Exactly, but it does make a difference.
Okay, so what causes latency then?
The key determinator is distance. A track such as Silverstone, which is relatively close to MTC, it's about 80 miles away, the time or the latency to move data from the F1 car to the base is around 56 milliseconds. If you compare that to Melbourne in Australia, the other side of the world, it takes around 600 milliseconds, so almost 10 times slower. Then again, it is 10,000 miles away.
Yeah, but then if you're not there when your data arrives, does somebody leave it behind a bin or with a neighbour?
Okay, so let's test your maths. How long would it take for data to travel from an F1 car at the US Grand Prix back to the MTC?
Okay, so let's say Austin, Texas to Woking in the UK. That's probably around half the distance to Australia, so presumably half the amount of time?
Correct, it's about 300 milliseconds.
Wow. Okay, well, thank goodness for that. None of that boring sitting around for 300 milliseconds waiting for your data to arrive. So, Stephen, do we experience latency in our everyday lives?
I'm afraid we do. So when you open a web page, some open quicker than others. The time it takes is a good indication of latency. And sometimes when you watch something on Netflix or YouTube, the quality isn't always great at the start, but within a short time, it becomes HD quality.
Yeah, been there, done that.
And this is where the bigger the bandwidth makes a difference, as your home internet has the opportunity to receive more data from the internet.
So how do McLaren deal with this?
Over a race weekend, McLaren need to manage their bandwidth to ensure the data from the car, as well as radio communications, are sent clearly and in high quality.
Ah, so just like that YouTube video.
Precisely. And as quickly as possible.
Ah, like loading a web page.
You've got it. Otherwise, drivers may miss the opportunity to make a pit stop.
Ah, yes. So how much bandwidth then do McLaren actually need for a Grand Prix weekend?
Over a race weekend, each team has access to 100 megabits of data. The bandwidth is diverted between different users, so 70% of that is reserved for the team's telemetry, communications, and the other bandwidth is used for less important race activities.
Like sending selfies?
Once the race is finished, all of the bandwidth is diverted to transfer all of the data back here as quickly as possible.
Ah, okay, so then that's another late night for mission control.
That's F1. It never, ever stops.
So we've been schooled on bandwidth and latency, but now we're going to put our newfound knowledge to the test.
That's right, we've devised a simple experiment for you to try at home, demonstrating the importance of increasing bandwidth and decreasing the latency in a network.
Now, I'm assuming that these are props and not for my dinner.
You'll need a cup full of frozen peas, 4 tumblers and 3 different tubes.
So that's a toilet paper roll, a kitchen paper roll, or a plastic bottle with the ends removed.
You could even use some rolled up paper sealed with sellotape.
Clever. So what happens next?
Each individual pea will represent a vital piece of data. The challenge is to transfer every single pea using 1 tumbler to the next using a different tube each time.
This is harder than it looks.
Measure the time it takes from start to finish. Try this 3 or 4 different times until you've got a system. Congratulations, you've made yourself a network.
And you're racing to transfer data.
Now ask yourself, how could you improve the speed of the process? It could be bigger glasses, wider tumblers, shorter tubes. Maybe it involves changing the shape and the size of the pea. Is there a quicker way of sending the data through the funnel?
Sneaky. Maybe you could use a pea shooter or perhaps even a hairdryer.
Experiment with a few different options. Then tell us your fastest method.
Brilliant. Now we would love to see how you got on, so please post your responses in the comment sections below. That's it for today's lesson. A big thanks to Stephen and to Dell Technologies. Just time for us to say a very quick goodbye. Goodbye.
Goodbye.